Yesterday, the first day of the impeachment trial started off with a bit of a bang, with the Democrats unveiling a video sort of summarizing the timeline of what happened on January 6th with Trump's speech and the violence, and then how Trump was begrudgingly forced to sort of tell them to go home. It's about 13 minutes long. It is available online. Obviously, we're not going to play the full thing, but here are a few of the highlights.
The steal. Today I will.
We outnumber you a million to one out here, dude.
Take the building! Take the building!
Such a thing happened where they could take it away from all of us, from me, from you, from our country. This was a fraudulent election, but we can't play into the hands of these people. We have to have peace. So go home. We love you. You're very special. You've seen what happened.
I mean, look, there was so much more there, but this whole thing is madness that there is any question at all with what he said, what all of his followers were saying that he said. All of them say that they were there for him. And then when, like, him telling them to go home, sort of, he was just saying, yeah, no, this is what happens. They stole the election from you. I love you. You're special. And then his tweet after, people were dead, bodies were already on the ground, and he's saying, this is what happens when they steal an election. And they're still saying, no, he didn't incite it. He had nothing to do with it. It is like, we if you pay attention to politics on a daily basis, you have to deal with a lot of bad faith BS. You have to deal with a lot of people who are clearly lying. But this is as dishonest to say that he bears no responsibility, that nothing should be done. This is the ultimate of that thing that is so core to our politics.
Yeah, if you can imagine, and I know this is the same argument it's made all the times, if they were actually looking at this case from someone that they didn't like, that they didn't support, that didn't uplift their party, because obviously this is a partisan thing for the Republicans to make sure that they uphold Donald Trump's, I don't know, they're not keeping him in office because he got voted out, but to make sure they uphold his name, or whatever they need to do to continue to please these folks like the ones that ran and ransacked the Capitol. The fact that they have to go this far, and this, with this disingenuous type of approach, just it shows the reasons why they didn't want to have this trial in the first place. Because they knew, remember, they kept saying, hey, we already know what we're going to vote for, we already know how this is going to go. They made sure, they wanted to make sure that this thing wouldn't get shown to the entire country in this manner. And then after all that, they're still going to acquit him. So that's going to make them look even worse, because anyone who looks at this will go, well, this is open and shut. 2 + 2 = 4, right? And then nearly every Republican senator will say, yeah, you know what? 2 + 3 = 3. 2 + 2 = 3 this time. I'm just saying, it's this way it's going to work out for us. And they look worse. They didn't want to have to be put in this situation. And now I wonder what they're going to do about it.
Yeah, I mean, they said that they didn't want the clips played ahead of time for obvious reasons, because the clips are damning. They don't want Trump's speech played. They don't want the footage of the attacks played, because they have been, since January 6th, starting on January 6th, they've been doing two things. One, they've been lying about what happened. And two, they've been desperately, desperately, desperately hoping that you forget what happened. But when you see that crowd chanting, no Trump, no peace, as they rip riot shields away from cops, as they bust in there, like, we need patriots to the front. That isn't, well, we were just walking, like, we were just visiting to see the art. No, it was a violent mob. That's all it was. And so many people, some obvious, you know, on the right, have tried to redefine what that was. But a lot of people, I think, because it's been a bit and a lot has happened since then, have allowed themselves to go along with it. No, it was everything that you remember. That crowd that he loved and is very special. And this is what happens when they unceremoniously steal an election. Remember, he was still saying it was stolen after. He's still saying it was stolen now. Like after all of this, he's still saying that it's stolen. His lawyer came out yesterday and said that he had lost, but Trump still has not admitted that he lost. I get that like none of this changes the outcome. None of this has any effect. While that video was playing, people like Rand Paul were like doodling in notebooks. Yep. Like, I find this so boring that this mob wanted to kill me and they murdered a cop. I'm just bored by this because we're not governed by serious people. We're not governed by sane people. We're not governed by people who feel any obligation to democracy or the Constitution or any norms or the constituents or anything like that. They're just, they're political animals. They're concerned about their political careers. They're concerned about not getting canceled by Fox News or whatever, so they can keep selling stupid books. The whole thing is just so pointless, and it's not going away.
There was one small other point of that video, of part of that video, that because I went through a lot of it yesterday, where at that, again, the speech that incited them to finally make their move, he said, you know, when there's a fraud, when you bust someone for fraud, he goes, the rules change. You suddenly don't have to do things by those same rules anymore. In other words, hey, normally we wouldn't be storming the Capitol, but in this particular instance, since the election was stolen from me and you and the American people, we have to take our country back, and the rules have changed. What else does that mean? So we had Sarah Palin on Good Morning Britain yesterday and everything, and what they need in her ridiculous argument, what they need is for Donald Trump to say, hey, everybody, every one of you, and number how many people are there, all of you must go to the Capitol right now, break through the window, grab a fire hydrant, grab a fire extinguisher, throw it at people, take your flags and bang through the windows. Hey, cuss at people, tell them you're gonna come find them, chase Capitol Police around. He has to say explicitly everything that you did in order for you to believe that he incited them to do it. It doesn't make any sense, and they don't really believe it either. It's just, let's just get through this so we can go ahead and acquit him over nothing.
Exactly. None of it's true. They don't actually believe that it wasn't incitement. They don't actually believe that you can't convict a guy that when he's not the president anymore. And them saying, well, this is going to open the door to us doing it in the future. No, nothing's, no doors being opened. Republicans don't have doors and doorways. They just go wherever they want. That's what they're doing. Nothing is changing based on this. And also, let's remember, it's only a couple of weeks ago, so it shouldn't be too hard to remember. The only reason we're debating whether you can convict a president who's not the president anymore is because the Republicans didn't allow the trial to go forward before the inauguration. Okay, so they stopped it from going forward, and then they said, well, now it's too late. Teehee, oh, look at the situation we ended up in. No, I'm not stupid, I'm not a child, I know what you did. And we know that you don't think that you can't convict someone who's not president anymore. There's no January exception. There's no the purge in late January where a president can do whatever they want and then just squeak through to the inauguration and then there's no consequences. That isn't how it works. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.